हॅलो, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर ए एन बसुगडे, प्रोफेसर अँड हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ स्टॅटिस्टिक्स, गोपालकृष्ण गोखले कॉलेज, कोल्हापूर. टुडे वी आर डीलिंग विथ द टॉपिक डिमोग्राफी. इन दिस टॉपिक वील स्टडी द वाइटल स्टॅटिस्टिक्स, यूज ऑफ वाइटल स्टॅटिस्टिक्स, then mortality rates, births or fertility rates, population growth rates, etc. Now we'll see what is vital statistics. Vital statistics means data or methods of studying vital events such as births and deaths in a population, or vital events we mean important events such as births, deaths, marriages, divorces, illnesses, etc. occurring in a human population. Sources of obtaining these vital statistics. There are three methods of obtaining vital statistics. The first one is registration method. Second method is a census method. And the third one is the sample survey method. Now we'll see what is the registration method. The registration method is the most important method of obtaining vital statistics. In most of the countries, vital statistics are registered and maintained by the government. It is compulsory to register the births, deaths, and marriages. The second method is a census method. In almost all the countries in the world, census will be carried out after every 10 years. Various information of an individual regarding their ages, sex, education, marital status, occupation, religion, etc. is collected during the census. The third method is the sample survey. When the population is very large, then it is very difficult to collect the information by census method from each and every individual of a population, and hence we are generally employing this sample survey method. When up-to-date information is required, or when registration of deaths and births is not reliable, then sample surveys are conducted. In a sample survey, a part of population is selected and is to be studied. That is, a small part of a population is called as a sample, and that is collected and that is to be studied. From the sample, using proper statistical methods, we can estimate the characteristics of the population. National Sample Survey conducts such type of surveys. Now we'll see what is the population measure. The population at any time t is given by pt, that is p naught plus b minus d plus I minus e, where these notations given here are: P naught is total population at last census, whatever census. So in India, we have got the census in 2011. So that is P naught value. Then B is the total births during last census to this time, T. Now till this date, what are the total number of births till today? That means 2020. So that is denoted by B. Then D is the number of deaths during last census to time T. So till this date, from 2011 to till this date, what are the number of deaths? That is denoted by D. I is total immigrants during last census to time T. So immigrants means the people who came from other countries from 2011 to till this date. So that is I. And E is the total number of emigrants during last census to time T. So how many people are going out of this country? That is to be denoted by this E. So your formula for this population at time T is P naught plus births, total births minus total number of deaths plus immigrants minus emigrants. So this is the formula and these are the notations. Now, how to measure the mortality? Mortality means deaths, okay, death rates. So the first method to measure the mortality rate is crude death rate, denoted by CDR, which is the annual crude death rate is defined as the ratio of number of deaths in a given period to the total population. That means mathematically we can write this formula as CDR is equal to total annual deaths into divided by total population into 1000. So that is the formula. So total, how many deaths are there during that period, divided by total population, multiply by 1000 will give the CDR. CDR generally lies between 3 to 23 per 1000. At present, we are having per minute 19 deaths in India. And the births will be about 51. The CDR does not take into account the age group or the sex. So in the calculation of CDR, we cannot consider what is the age group and what is the sex. Generally, the population of deaths in the age group 0 to 10 and above 60, that is child deaths and old age deaths, are much larger in comparison to the proportion of deaths in the remaining age group, that is between 10 to 60. The crude death rate can be used to compare mortality at same place at different times if the periods are not separated far away. The second method is specific death rate, that is SDR. The crude death rate gives us a general picture of mortality situation at a given place in a given year. If we want more information about mortality, such as mortality in a specific age group or a specific sex or for a specific locality, then specific death rates are to be calculated, and they are obtained by this formula. That is SDR equal to the total number of deaths in specific section of a population in a given period divided by total population in specified section in given period multiplied by 1000. Of all the specific death rates, age-specific death rates are highly useful and more commonly used. They are very important for life insurance companies for fixing the premiums. And therefore, the ASDR, that is age-specific death rate, is given by the formula total number of deaths in a specified age group in given period divided by total population in specified age group in a given period multiplied by 1000. We observe that the ASDR, that is age specific death rate, is very high in first year of a child. Then it slowly decreases as age increases and reaches a minimum and remains more or less steady for some period, say up to the age of 45, and then it again increases after the age 50. The third method, third formula for obtaining mortality rate is infant mortality rate, IMR. What do you mean by infant mortality rate? Infant mortality rate is the age-specific death rate of babies before completing the first year, and it is defined as IMR equal to total number of deaths before completing 1 year divided by total number of live births during the year multiplied by 1000. The next part is standardized death rates. Age specific death rate is is useful for age wise comparisons of mortality of two populations or 2 years, but it may happen that ASDR for one population is higher in some age group than that of the other age group. Thus, we need a unique representative value of all SDRs. This can be obtained using weighted average of SDRs. Here, to compare two SDRs, a third population, which is to be known as a standard population, is taken. There are two methods of calculating standardized death rates. The first one is called as a direct method, and the second one is called as an indirect method. In direct method, let Pi of S is a standard population of ith age group. Mi of A is age specific death rate of ith age group in population A. Mi of B is the age specific death rate of ith age group of population B. Then the standardized death rate STDR of population A is given by STDR is equal to summation Mi of A into Pi of S divided by summation Pi of S. And the standardized death rate of population B is given by the formula STDR of B is equal to Mi of B into Pi of S divided by summation Pi of S. So using these two formulas, one can calculate the standardized death rates for different populations. The other method is indirect method. If the age-specific death rates of the population are not available, standard death rates, STDRs, cannot be calculated. In such cases, under certain assumptions, approximate values of STDR can be obtained by multiplying CDR, that is crude death rate, by the adjustment factor, which is defined as C as an adjustment factor is equal to summation Mi of A Pi of S divided by Pi of S, and whole thing again divided by summation Mi of S into Pi of a divided by summation pi of a. Thus, the STDR is given by C into CDR of A. But generally, Mi of A are unknown, and hence we replace Mi of A by Mi of S and estimate the value of C and denoted by C hat, which is given by summation Mi of S into Pi of S divided by summation Pi of S divided by summation Mi of S Pi of A into summation Pi of A. And therefore, the STDR is given by C hat into CDR of A. Now, we'll see one example to obtain STDR of population A and B by direct method. So, given age groups are 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 60 and 60 to 100. The number of persons are given in each age group, that is PI values are given as 600, 1000, then 3000, 400, total is 5000, and total deaths in that population of A are given as 18, 5, 24, 20, total are 67. Similarly, for population B, these values are given. Now, we'll obtain Mi of A as 18 multiplied by 1000 into 600, that will turn out to be 30, then 5, 8 and 50. Then we'll multiply this Mi of A into Pi of S. So Pi of S means 30 into 400, so that would turn out to be 1200. Similarly, other values, that Mi of A into Pi of S. Similarly, Mi of B is obtained using the same formula as Mi of A. So that is 44, then 10 and 30. Then the lastly, we'll obtain it as Mi of B into Pi of S as 16,000, 6,000 and so on. That is, total will be 67,000. Then the STDR of A is obtained by summation Mi of A into Pi of S divided by summation Pi of S, and that will be 73,700 divided by 5,000, that will be 14.75, and same is the case for B, it is turned out to be 13.4. Thus, the STDR of B is less than the STDR of A. Thus, we can say that population B is more healthy than population A because the death rate is less, standardized death rate is less. Thank you very much.